गुड आफ्टरनून। ओके, गुड आफ्टरनून। टुडे वी विल सी वर्चुअल नंबर ऑफ टीथ, फोर्स एनालिसिस, प्रॉब्लम ऑन फोर्स एनालिसिस एंड मे बी बीम स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ बीविल गियर। देयरफॉर वर्चुअल नंबर ऑफ टीथ एज शोन इन फिगर, एन इमेजिनरी स्पर गियर इज कंसिडर्ड इन अ प्लेन परपेंडिकुलर टू द टूथ एट द लार्ज एंड। आर बी इज द पिच सर्कल रेडियस ऑफ दिस इमेजिनरी स्पर गियर एंड जेड डैश इज द नंबर ऑफ टीथ ऑन दिस गियर। दैट इज जेड डैश इज नथिंग बट इमेजिनरी नंबर ऑफ टीथ और वर्चुअल नंबर ऑफ टीथ। द गियर इज कॉल्ड द फॉर्मेटिव गियर एंड द नंबर ऑफ टीथ जेड डैश ऑन दिस गियर इज कॉल्ड द वर्चुअल और द फॉर्मेटिव नंबर ऑफ टीथ। देयरफॉर हियर ए नॉट इज नथिंग बट कोन डिस्टेंस, एच ए इज नथिंग बट अडेंडम, एच एफ डिडेंडम, देन गैमा इज नथिंग बट पिच एंगल, कैपिटल डी इज नथिंग बट पिच सर्कल डायमीटर एट द लार्ज एंड, ओ इज नथिंग बट अपेक्स पॉइंट, आर बी इज नथिंग बट पिच सर्कल रेडियस ऑफ द इमेजिनरी स्पर गियर। देयरफॉर द फॉर्मेटिव नंबर ऑफ टीथ जेड डैश इज गिवन बाय जेड डैश इज इक्वल टू 2 RB/m, वेयर एम इज इक्वल टू मॉड्यूल एट द लार्ज एंड ऑफ द टूथ एंड जेड इज द एक्चुअल नंबर ऑफ टीथ ऑन बीविल गियर। Therefore, we are knowing that capital Z is equal to capital D divided by M. Therefore, equating these two equations or dividing these two equations, Z dash divided by Z is equal to 2 RB divided by D. Now, from triangle ABC, ABC, sine of angle BCA, BCA is equal to AB divided by AC. Therefore, which is equal to sine of 90 minus gamma is equal to AB means capital D divided by 2 and AC means RB, therefore D divided by 2 RB, therefore RB is equal to D divided by 2 cos gamma. Therefore, if you will substitute this value of RB here, therefore we are getting it as Z dash is equal to Z divided by cos of gamma. Now, a pair of bevel gears is shown in figure. This is known as small gamma, this is known as capital gamma or large gamma. A pair of bevel gears is shown in figure. DP and DG are the pitch circle diameters of pinion and gear respectively. Gamma is the pitch angle of the pinion, while capital gamma is the pitch angle of the gear. Line AB is perpendicular to the OB. AB is perpendicular to OB. Consider triangle OAB, tan gamma is equal to DP divided by 2 divided by DG divided by 2. Now tan of gamma is equal to DP divided by DG, therefore tan of gamma is equal to MZP divided by MZG, therefore tan of gamma is equal to ZP divided by ZG. Similarly, tan of capital gamma is equal to ZG divided by ZP. Also, small gamma plus capital gamma is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, the cone distance A0 is given by A0 is equal to square root of dp divided by 2 bracket square plus dg divided by 2 bracket square. Now, we will see force analysis. In force analysis, it is assumed that the resultant tooth force between two meshing teeth of a pair of bevel gears is concentrated at the midpoint along the face width of the tooth. This is illustrated in figure where the resultant force P shown by the dotted line acts at the midpoint capital D of the face width of the pinion. The resultant force has following three components. PT is equal to tangential or useful component because it is useful for power transmission, that's why it is known as useful component. PR is nothing but radial component in Newton. PA is equal to axial component or thrust component in Newton. Now you are observing this diagram. This is known as pitch cone of pinion, direction of rotation, it is anticlockwise. This is the apex point O. P dotted line indicates, that is line BD. Dotted line indicates resultant force P. Line CD indicates tangential force PT. Line FD indicates radial force PR. Line ED indicates axial force PA. And line AD indicates separating force PS. Therefore, we will see now the force analysis. We will find out these three components, equations for the three components. Now, from the triangle, from the rectangle ABCD, we have taken out rectangle from previous diagram. Consider the plane ABCD shaded by dots in figure and again shown in figure. From the triangle BCD, tan of alpha is equal to BC divided by CD. Now BC is nothing but AD, which is equal to PS. Therefore, tan of alpha is equal to PS divided by PT, equation 1, where PS is equal to separating force in Newton, alpha is equal to pressure angle in degrees. Therefore, PS is equal to PT tan alpha, equation 2. The separating force PS is perpendicular to the pitch line OD. Therefore, AD is perpendicular to OD. Line FD is vertical while the line OX is horizontal. Therefore, FD is perpendicular to OX. There are two pairs of perpendicular lines and their included angle should be equal. The angle between lines OD and OX should be equal to the angle between the lines AD and FD. The angle between lines OD and OX is the pitch angle gamma. Therefore, the angle between lines AD and FD should be equal to the pitch angle gamma. Now, again, we have to consider the plane DEAF. From the triangle ADF, we are getting it as PR is equal to PS cos gamma and PA is equal to PS sin gamma. Therefore, substituting equation 2 in the above expressions, we are getting PR is equal to PT tan alpha into cos gamma, equation 3. PA is equal to PT tan alpha into sin gamma, equation 4. Therefore, the tangential component is determined from the following relationship. PT is equal to MT divided by RM, equation 5, where MT is equal to torque transmitted by gears in Newton mm, which we will get from the power transmission. RM is equal to mean radius of the pinion at the midpoint along the face width in mm, where RM is equal to dP divided by 2 minus B sin gamma divided by 2. From equations 3, 4 and 5, or equations 3, 4 and 5 are used to determine the components of the tooth force on the pinion. The components of the tooth force acting on the gear can be determined by considering actions and reactions as equal and opposite. As seen in figure C, this is the figure. The radial component on the gear is equal to axial component on the pinion. Radial component on the gear is equal to axial component on the pinion. This is axial component. This is separating force. This is radial component. Similarly, the axial component of the gear is equal to the radial component on the pinion. This is radial component. This is radial component on the pinion. This is axial component on the gear. This is axial component on the pinion. This is radial component on the gear. Therefore, we will see the problem. Therefore, please write down the problem. Example 1. A pair of bevel gears transmitting 7.5 kW at 300 rpm is shown in figure. The pressure angle is 20 degree. Determine the components of the resultant gear tooth force and draw a free body diagram of forces acting on the pinion and the gear. Therefore, the diagram is shown here. Pinion, to the pinion, input power is provided at 7.5 kW and 300 rpm. Therefore, pinion rotates at 300 rpm. Pitch circle diameter of pinion is 150 mm. Pitch circle diameter of gear is 200 mm. Face width is equal to 40 mm. Pressure angle alpha is equal to 20 degree. Therefore, we will solve this problem. Solution. given data. Given first of all kilowatt is equal to 7.5. Then speed of pinion NP is equal to 300 rpm. Then alpha, pressure angle alpha is equal to 20 degree. They have given. Then pitch circle diameter of pinion is equal to 150 mm. Pitch circle diameter of gear is equal to 200 mm. Face width. Face width B is equal to 40 mm. Therefore, we will calculate first of all torque transmitted. Therefore, we are knowing the formula. Kilowatt is equal to 2 pi NPMT divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6. Therefore, 7.5 is equal to 2 pi into 300 into MT divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6. Therefore, MT is equal to, therefore, we are getting it as 238,732.41 Newton mm. Torque we are getting it as like this. Therefore, we will find out tan gamma, pitch angle we will find out. Tan of gamma is equal to Zp upon Zg, which is equal to dp upon dg, which is equal to 150 upon 200, which is equal to 0.75. therefore, tan of gamma is equal to 0.75. therefore, gamma is equal to, we are getting it as 36.87 degree. Now we will find out mean radius. Mean radius Rm is equal to into bracket dp divided by 2 minus b sin gamma divided by 2, which is equal to 150 divided by 2 minus 40 into sine of 36.87 divided by 2, therefore mean radius Rm is equal to 63 mm. Therefore, we will find out now components of the forces. Therefore, tangential force PT is equal to MT divided by RM, which is equal to 238,732.41 divided by 63. Therefore, PT is equal to 3,789.40 Newton. Now we will find out radial force and axial force. Therefore, radial force PR is equal to PT tan alpha into cos of gamma. Therefore, substitute the values. PR is equal to 3789.40 into tan of 20 degree into cos of 36.87. Therefore, PR is equal to 1103.38 newton. Now we will find out axial force. Axial force PA is given by PT tan alpha into sine of gamma, which is equal to 3789.40 into tan of 20 degree into sine of 36.87. Therefore, axial force PA is equal to 827.54 newton. Now we have determined these three components of the forces. Now we will see the free body diagram of the forces acting on the pinion and gear. Therefore, here you are observing that this dot represents the tangential force which is acting perpendicular to the plane of the paper or perpendicular to the slide. Therefore, its value is 3789.40. Now, we have found out components acting on the pinion. Therefore, radial force is nothing but this. Radial force PR. PR is equal to, this is PT is equal to 1103, and this value is nothing but PA. Now we have seen that radial force on the pinion is equal to axial force on the gear. Therefore, this is the axial force PA. And axial force on the pinion is equal to radial force on the gear. Therefore, this is the value of PR for the gear. And this value is nothing but PT. This value is the PT. Therefore, this is nothing but force analysis on the gear, pinion and gear. Now, next point, that is beam strength of bevel gears. We have seen in case of spur gear and helical gear, beam strength is nothing but it is the capacity of the gear to transmit maximum tangential force without bending. Therefore, the size of the cross section of the tooth of a bevel gear varies along the face width as shown in figure. Therefore, this is the size. This varies along the face width. See that at the smaller end, this height is different. At the larger end, height is different. That is, addendum and addendum are different at the smaller end and at the large end. In order to determine the beam strength of the tooth of a bevel gear, it is considered to be equivalent to a formative spur gear in a plane perpendicular to the tooth element. Therefore, we have to just extend this project and we have to consider here a formative spur gear perpendicular to the tooth element. Consider an elemental section of the tooth at a distance x from the apex O and having a width dx. Applying the Lewis equation to a formative spur gear at a distance x from the apex. Therefore, we have to apply Lewis equation to this a small element dx. Then we will integrate it. Therefore, delta SB is equal to MX into BX into sigma B into Y. Y is nothing but Lewis form factor. Sigma is nothing but bending stress, sigma B. Therefore, this is the equation 1, where delta SB is equal to beam strength of the elemental section in Newton. MX is equal to module of the section in mm. BX is equal to face width of elemental section in mm. Y is equal to Lewis form factor based on virtual number of teeth. Therefore, from the figure, we can write Rx upon R, that is this Rx, vertical distance, upon capital R is equal to x divided by a naught. Therefore, Rx is equal to xr divided by a naught, equation 2. At the elemental section, mx is equal to 2rx upon z, which is equal to 2 into x into capital R divided by z into a naught, equation 3. At the large end of the tooth, m is equal to 2r divided by z, equation 4. Therefore, from equations 3 and 4, mx is equal to m into bracket x divided by a naught, equation 5. Also, bx is equal to dx, equation 6. Therefore, substituting equations 5 and 6 in equation 1, we are getting delta sb is equal to m into sigma b into y x dx divided by a naught, equation 7. Now, we will integrate. Therefore, from equation 2 and 7, integration of rx into delta sb is equal to into bracket m sigma b into y into r divided by a naught square into integration of x square dx, equation 8. The left hand side indicates the torque mt, that is mt is equal to into bracket m sigma b y into r divided by a naught square integration of a naught minus b to the a naught x square dx, therefore which is equal to m sigma b y into r divided by a naught square x cube divided by 3, it varies from a naught minus b to a naught. Therefore, mt is equal to mb sigma b into y into r into bracket 1 minus b divided by a naught plus b square divided by 3 a naught square, equation 9. Assuming beam strength sb as the tangential force at the large end of the tooth, therefore mt is equal to sb into r, equation 10. Therefore, from equations 9 and 10, sb is equal to mb sigma b into y into bracket 1 minus b divided by a naught plus b square divided by 3 a naught square, bracket complete. The face width of the bevel gear is limited to 1/3 of the cone distance. Therefore, the last term in the bracket will never be more than 1 divided by 27. Therefore, neglecting the last term, we are getting the equation as sb is equal to mb sigma b into y into bracket 1 minus b divided by a naught, equation 11. Equation 11 is known as Lewis equation for bevel gears, where sb is equal to beam strength of the tooth in Newton, m is equal to module at the large end of the tooth in mm, b is equal to face width in mm, sb is equal to permissible bending stress, which is equal to SU2 divided by 3 in Newton per mm square, y is equal to Lewis form factor based on formative number of teeth, a naught is equal to cone distance in mm. The term 1 minus b divided by a naught is called the bevel factor. Therefore, in the above analysis, the beam strength sb is determined using the pitch radius capital R at the large end of the tooth, that is sb is equal to mt divided by capital R. Therefore, the beam strength indicates the maximum value of the tangential force at the large end of the tooth that the tooth can transmit. Without bending failure, it is necessary to compare the beam strength with an imaginary force Pt considered to be acting at the large end of the tooth. This component is given by Pt is equal to 2mt divided by capital D. The beam strength should always be more than the effective force between the meshing teeth at the large end of the tooth. The face width of the bevel gear is generally taken as 10 times module or a naught divided by 3, whichever is smaller, that is b is equal to 10m or b is equal to a naught divided by 3. Therefore, we will stop here today. In next lecture, we will see wear strength and effective load between the two bevel gears. Thank you very much.